This is my last video before election day, so it's time for some real talk. I've been involved in left-wing politics for 40 years, and I've learned the only way to win is to play the long game. This is the frustrating reality that progressives must face about American electoral politics. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. You might even say it's a long-distance relay race, with each generation passing the baton to the next. If you support a livable minimum wage, Medicare for all, a Green New Deal, student loan debt relief, universal basic income, an equitable tax system, legalizing marijuana, abolishing the death penalty, eliminating the Electoral College, Palestinian statehood, reparations for Black people, restoring reproductive rights, reinstating affirmative action, banning assault weapons, and moving government resources away from aggressive policing to vital public services, all of which I support, no presidential candidate can deliver this for you. Not Kamala Harris, not Jill Stein, not Cornel West, and certainly not Donald Trump. In our system of government, we need Congress, governors, state legislatures, and judges to sign off on all of that. And that takes time to build the infrastructure, a system that was never designed for us. So what happens is that some of us understandably withdraw from the electoral process when we don't get what we want in a timely fashion. This is exactly what our opponents want us to do. The wealthy white male property owners who created our archaic system of government purposely made it difficult to change the status quo. They did not allow women or Black people to vote, did not allow direct election of presidents, did not allow citizens to vote for U.S. senators, counted enslaved people as only 3/5 of a person, and required a virtually unattainable supermajority of 3/4 of the states to amend the Constitution. That is why Audre Lorde reminds us that the master's tools will never dismantle the master's house. And that's why our opponents don't have to work that hard to slow us down. They know that the system is on their side if they can just wait us out. In physics, they call it the law of inertia. An object at rest will remain at rest until acted upon by an outside force. In American politics, we call it the government. But the other side of inertia is that an object in motion will remain in motion until another force causes it to rest. We are the object in motion, and as Sweet Honey in the Rock instructs us, we who believe in freedom cannot rest until it comes. I've cast a ballot in all 11 presidential elections in which I was eligible to vote in my life from 1984 to the present. I've never agreed with any candidate on every issue. I worked for Bill Clinton's 92 campaign, even though I vehemently disagreed with his support of capital punishment. But you know what? Bill Clinton appointed two Supreme Court justices, Ruth Bader Ginsburg and Stephen Breyer, who voted to abolish the death penalty 2 decades later. I voted for Barack Obama in 2008, even though I fundamentally disagreed with his opposition to gay marriage. And you know what? Obama appointed two Supreme Court justices, Sonia Sotomayor and Elena Kagan, who cast a deciding vote to legalize same-sex marriage. And I voted for Joe Biden in 2020, even though I spent months on CNN debating other Democrats because I felt we needed a younger, more progressive candidate. But you know what? Biden appointed Ketanji Brown Jackson, who has led the charge to protect voting rights, reproductive rights, student loan debt forgiveness, affirmative action, and other progressive priorities against the conservative 6-3 Trump-dominated court. Presidential campaigns have become the worst place to debate divisive issues because successful candidates avoid controversial matters like Gaza and reparations to get elected. But that doesn't mean we have to be blind to which party is most on our side. I don't agree with them on every issue, but I'm more aligned with Raphael Warnock, Wes Moore, Pete Buttigieg, Elizabeth Warren, AOC, Bernie Sanders, Hakeem Jeffries, Maxine Waters, and Barbara Lee, all of whom are supporting Kamala Harris. I'm not aligned with hateful demagogues and opportunists like Ted Cruz, Tim Scott, Lindsey Graham, Jim Jordan, Ron DeSantis, Greg Abbott, Rudy Giuliani, and Marjorie Taylor Greene, all of whom support Donald Trump. A president can't fix all our problems in 4 years, but they can make things a lot worse. And the one presidential power that has the most enduring impact is the authority to appoint federal judges who serve with lifetime tenure. At 54 years old, Justice Ketanji Brown Jackson will be on the bench for another 20 to 25 years. If Trump appoints the next batch of judges, progressives will spend the next 20 years of our lives watching nearly every left-wing policy slowly and methodically struck down by the courts. That's the long game. It doesn't mean you stop pushing, critiquing, and holding candidates accountable after you vote for them. It means you create the infrastructure for the change you want to see in the world. Dr. King reminds us that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends toward justice. I am clear and certain that we are on the right side of history, but history doesn't happen by accident. It happens by action.